on My Big Show. Pop superstar Olly Murs hands over his phone to play Celebrity Centre Wall. There's a British television exclusive from hit new musical School of Rock. Music from the wonderful Ellie Goulding. And who will be tonight's unexpected star of the show? All this and so much more.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Big Show. Please welcome your host, Michael McIntyre.
The next 6 weeks, we will have even bigger stars, even bigger laughs, and even bigger surprises.
Oh. It's always a nice night out in the theatre. You know, go to the theatre, dress up, maybe. A little bit, it's quite expensive, you know. Maybe combine it with dinner and a show. It's quite a lovely evening. I always find it a bit weird eating, though, in the interval, when you eat ice cream with wood. It always feels a bit depressing. I've paid all this money and I'm having wood ice cream. Would you like some ice cream? It's like picnics. I don't see the value in a picnic. Because people think it's fun, don't they? It's like, let's have a picnic. It's always a lovely moment when people want to announce the idea. Let's have a picnic. And for some reason, we're programmed as British people to be incredibly enthusiastic about the prospect. So, oh, yes. Yes, let's have a picnic. We're going to have a picnic, guys. And it's never fun. It's never fun. Just eat in your own homes, OK? You go out with your rug. You look for a place furthest away from strangers. Let's not go here. They're here. Let's go over here. No, they're coming over there. What about this? This seems OK. Just stay at home. There are no strangers there at all. And then off you go with your rug. It takes a few attempts. The wind blows it back. No, come on. It's OK. No, I'll get there in the end. All right, kill it. All right, jump on it. It's fine. You hold that bit down. And then comes a very big challenge for men, because it doesn't matter how hard you are, how macho you are, it is impossible not to become extremely camp as soon as you get down for the picnic. Men are completely restricted by the picnic pose. You can't really do... This is basically it. This arm is for stability. This one is for grazing. I'm just grazing. When I'm not grazing, it just rests here on my knee. I'm in a ready-to-graze situation. Can you pass me the hot Coca-Cola, please? I'm having such a lovely time. I love hot Coca-Cola. And the fear of a football hitting me in the head. And of course, that's when the bees and the wasps start to chip in for your day, because they live outside, OK? So they'll start to come into your life. And you'll deal with the situation, I believe, as a British person, in one of three ways. You'll recognise yourself in this as we go through it. When a bee or a wasp buzzes into your life, bzzz. Either you are, firstly, a wafter, OK? You'll know who you are if you're the wafters. They're quite cool, by the way. If you're a wafter, you're quite cool. You just deal with the situation. Bzzz. OK, off you go. I don't need that. Bzzz. Sure. Sometimes you don't even break stride in your conversations. So the other day you've just dealt with the situation. You're moving the air. You're not trying to hit it. I'm just going to move the air near you. And you know that this isn't an area where you're particularly welcome. Okay? I'm a wafter. Right, next up, secondly, you have the stay stillers. Now, they are very serious people. And they're very adamant that their strategy is the best one to deal with the situation. Okay, nobody move. Just stay completely still. Don't make it angry. Don't encourage it. They get quite angry with the wafters. Don't waft it. You're just making it angry. You're encouraging it. Don't encourage it. It's not interested in us, and we're not interested in it. See? It's gone now. Just stay completely still, and it'll get about its business. Okay? Then, the third way, the total panickers. Right? Has it gone? you see it was massive? Oh, my God. Was it a hornet? Was it a hornet? You know, if it gets you on the throat, you can die. You can die. That's the third way. Now, wafters are able to upgrade and become total panickers. They allow themselves that privilege. You know? If things, if their wafting is ineffective and the wasp keeps coming back, then you can see them start to panic. Which is why wafters really hardly ever get stung. And total panickers almost never get stung. You know who gets stung? The stay stillers. Because they cannot break out of their seriousness. They are such firm believers that they have the right strategy. And this is why I thought of this. I've got a friend, he's a stay stiller. And a wasp not only buzzed around him, but landed on his face. And he just went, the best thing to do is stay completely still. I'm not so sure about that. It's on your face. I don't want to encourage it. But you're just encouraging it to crawl into your eye. It's walking towards your eye. He's like, no, the best thing to... It's not interested in me. It seems pretty interested in you. Why don't you waft it? The worst thing I could do is waft it. Just stay completely still. Then another one landed on the other side of his face. I'm like, dude, you now have two wafts on your face. And then it stung him. I've got to say, it was one of the funniest things I've ever seen. Because he couldn't just scream. He had to make out that he was still in the right. And he just went... It has now stung me. It stung my face. It stung me on the face. But I think the best thing to do is to not encourage it to sting me again. If a total panicker gets stung, you know about it. Ladies and gentlemen, who wants to play Celebrity Send-to-All? Oh, yes. This is, of course, where I take a celebrity's mobile phone, send a message of my choosing to their contacts, and we see what fun replies they get at the end of the show. So let's find out who's in our Royal Send-to-All box this week. Why? It's heartthrob Ollie Merz-Martin!
Michael!
How are you?
You okay?
Yeah.
It's good to see you.
Ollie, tell me who you're with tonight in the box.
I'm with my mum.
Oh, it's Mum. Mama Merz! Yeah. Hi, Mum!
Mum.
Hello.
My lovely sister.
In the middle. Hi.
And Auntie Rachel.
Oh, hi, Auntie Rach. Yay, it's a family affair. It's the Merzes! So, Ollie, what have you been up to? What's been happening?
I've just been a bit of this, bit of that. New music's out, new single.
All your music is awesome.
Well, that's very kind, mate.
I like that old one when you start with the letter dear.
Dear darling.
How did that? Did the letter go dear?
Please excuse my writing.
Please? Yeah, I love that one. Please excuse my writing. Why didn't you type it or send the text?
I don't know why. But that's what you're going to do tonight.
That's exactly right. I'm not going to... maybe that's the text I'll send to everyone on your phone. Dear darling, please excuse my texting. I can't thank you enough for being here, and it's going to be fun. So if I could just ask you to place your mobile telephone into our little cushion there, I'll bring it down and we'll play Celebrity Send to All. Here we go. Yeah! Yeah, I love that one! Right, ladies and gentlemen, I am now in possession of Ollie Merz's mobile phone. Merzy! Right, so I'm going to plug that in here. All right, so this is Ollie Merz's life.
Boring.
Uber, get me out of here! I've never used it before. Is it good?
I don't know.
This is your last journey. Did you have a nice trip?
It was lovely, thank you, yeah.
Not according to that rating. No!
That'd be nice.
Should we give him 5 stars?
Yeah.
That's very sweet. We're going to give him 5 stars. I have to book another car. That's hilarious. I'm going to book a car. How do I do that? What do I do? What do I do?
Press the arrow, get the location.
So that's where I am, yep. The theatre.
And then you pick at the bottom which one you want to get. Yeah.
Well, of course, the best one.
That would be the Lux.
Lux. I accept the higher fare. My destination? Heaven. Where should we go? We can go anywhere! Where do you want to go? Let's go to Basildon. Basildon, UK. All right. We'll let your driver know. All right, are we on? Oh, there he is! So we have a man, Ionut Vazil, and he's on his way. He's in a BMW 7 Series. And we need to... How do I know what to give him money?
You pay for it at the end of the journey.
Yeah, but there will... I can't go to Basildon. I've got to... All right, that's that. Oh, what's that? Oh, these are your photos. Wait a minute! I recognise that guy. That's you and Pelé.
Yes.
Please tell me you've got his phone number.
I haven't, unfortunately.
Oh, if you did, we would just play send to Pelé. It would be... Oh, hello.
Oh, cool.
What's going on here then, Ollie? Where are you?
I was in Vegas. I was there for a music shoot.
I love how you roll.
For a video, and then me and the lads decided to have a few days celebrating
birthdays.
I wish I
was you. I don't have lads. I have me and my family. And we go to family-friendly holidays. And I spend about 3 hours blowing that up, and then they don't play with it. Hang on. I've just received a text. Ionut Vazil is arriving now. Okay, let's get into this text, because your phone is too much fun already. I'm slightly worried about Ionut arriving. OK. The text, Ollie, that I'm going to send into your phone is as follows. Just going through the contacts in my phone. Really sorry. But can you remind me how I know you? Or I'm going to have to delete you.
Brilliant.
How would you sign the text?
Just a kiss? Just a little.
I'm not sure this is the right situation for kisses. It has to be quite a clinical.
You can pick whatever you fancy.
I'll just leave it, Ollie.
Yeah?
Ollie, yeah. Okay. So, let's remind ourselves of this text. Just going through the contacts in my phone, really sorry, but can you remind me how I know you? Or I'm going to have to delete you, Ollie. Shall I send that to everyone in Ollie's phone?
Yeah!
All right. That has gone, ladies and gentlemen! I'm gonna.
What are you doing?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's Ionut! Our unexpected star of the show! I need a microphone. On you. Ionut, am I saying that right, Ionut?
Yes.
So, listen, do you like music?
Of course.
You like pop music?
Everything.
If I was to say, dear darling, please excuse my writing, I can't stop my hands from shaking. Does that ring any bells with you?
No.
This gentleman on the left, recognise him at all? listen, Ionut, I want to make this worth your while. Is there anybody who needs to go to Basildon? How much do I owe you for the trip to Basildon?
around 200.
Have you got a credit card or something?
It's already been charged.
Oh, does it already get charged?
Yeah.
Does that already get charged automatically?
Yes.
But maybe you should have a deal. Can we have a whip round? Hold on, Anna. We got a tip. We need a tip. Can I get a whip round? Anything. Come on, anything. Get your money out. We've got 2,000 people in here. Don't just look at me blankly. Has anyone got a tenner? £5? Ollie's mum. Put it in the thing, Ollie. Ollie's mum. Dear darling. Please excuse my... OK, what we got? Let's see how generous he is. Please excuse my writing. I can't stop my hands from shaking. Yeah, it's gone quite well. I got 20 quid, 20 squid. By the way, you smell amazing. What is that? It's amazing.
Nice combination.
It's a combination. What? Oh, God, it's like really, really good. What's the combination? So, wait a minute, you're combining colognes?
Yes.
What's the combo you're going for?
I can't tell you now.
You won't reveal the combo? Is it in your car?
Yeah.
All right, that's for you. I can't thank you enough. Ina, thank you so much. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Ina! The unexpected driver of the show! Thank you very much. But nice to meet you. I cannot tell you how good that man smells. I was completely intoxicated. Do you see my eyes going? I was like, I've never said to a man in my life, you smell amazing. And his response was so awesome. Combination. The combination. Ollie, thank you so much. What an amazing sport is Ollie Mers, ladies and gentlemen. We will be finding out later what responses Ollie gets. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, what an absolute treat we have for you now with an exclusive performance from Andrew Lloyd Webber's brand new musical playing completely live for you tonight. It's the Magnificent Kids from the School of Rock.
Good evening, London. Say hello to the Demon Rascals of the School of Rock! When the world has screwed you and crushed you in its fist, when the way you're treated has got you in a twist, there's been one solution since the world began. Don't just sit and take it, stick it to the man. Rant and rave and scream and shout, get all of your aggression out. They try to stop you, let them know exactly where they ought to go. Doing just as loudly as you can, stick it to the man. Now if you want to rock, you gotta get angry at the man. Parents overwork ya,
stick it to the man.
Hate the way they jerk ya,
stick it to the man.
Stand up to the system,
stick it to the man.
Congratulations.
Hi, guys. Hi, guys.
One more time. What about that? The School of Rock. Come on. Yeah. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to find out who is going to be our unexpected star of the show. So, just a reminder, this is where somebody comes to the theatre and they think they're coming here for work, but really they have a secret desire to perform, and we give them that opportunity on this very stage. So, here is our unexpected star tonight. He is called Andy Quinn. Come on, let's hear it for Andy. He is 36 years old. He's from Nottingham, and he is a firefighter. And doesn't he look like... He does, apart from the fact his cardigan looks incredibly flammable, he looks like he can deal with fire and fight it at any moment. So that's Andy. And he is coming to this office next door to give a fire safety talk. So that is right next door. And let me show you what it looks like now. Yes, there it is. It's the MMBS Training Centre Limited, not a real company. Of course, that is in reference to the name of our television show, Michael McIntyre's Big Show. But he would have to have incredible intuition to see that and go, hang on a minute, that's the abbreviation for Michael McIntyre's Big Show. This is the fake room where Andy will be giving a talk, so we'll have six actors sitting down in these seats. But, of course, the real reason Andy is here is that he has a burning desire to perform on the West End stage, and we're going to make his dream come true. Yes! All right. He has been nominated by his lovely wife, Emma, and I'm going to have a chat with her. Where are you, Emma? There she is. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Emma, Andy's wife. Yeah! Emma!
Hello!
Is that you?
Yeah.
Oh, you look divine. So, Emma, this is very exciting. Tell us all about Andy.
Well, he's been a firefighter for about 13 years, and in his spare time, he does amateur musical theatre.
Okay.
Every time we come to London, he's always saying that he wants to be on the West End stage and he wishes he'd have had a go at it.
So it really is an unfulfilled passion. Did he do anything to try and be in musical theatre when he was younger?
Yeah, he went to do drama at university.
Right.
Then he realised that the uni lifestyle wasn't for him.
Okay.
So he followed in his dad's footsteps to become a fireman instead.
Is his dad here?
Yep. He's here.
Yeah! Hi, Dad! Good to see you. So you're a firefighter?
I'm retired, man.
Have you seen him perform?
Oh, many times, yeah.
How do you think he'll react, then, to tonight?
I don't know. He doesn't like surprises, though.
How do you think he'll be reacting tonight?
I think he'll be shocked, but I think when it sank in and he realises the opportunity that he's got.
But he should be good in a crisis, I mean,
in an emergency.
Okay, so thank you very much. It's Andy's wife, Emma. Thank you so much,
thank
darling.
You.
He doesn't like surprises. Okay. All right, well. We can now, I believe, go live to that very room, and there he is. And he's in his uniform, the Nottinghamshire Fire and Rescue Service. Can you confirm that is your husband and son? Yes? There he is. Let's listen in for a bit.
The most house fires will start in certain places, either those two are cooking, or to do electricity. Mm-hmm. So you kind of get the kitchen, there's always one, you know, the living room, you've got lots of things plugged in.
None of this is real! Quite exciting. Okay, so what's going to happen is someone's going to come up the stairs when I call them up and say they need help getting the fire extinguishers, and they're going to come down in through a corridor here, and then on the stage there'll be a storeroom with the fire extinguishers in them. As soon as he gets in there, then a fire alarm is going to go off, and the fire extinguishers are also going to go off and put foam all over him. Then water is going to come out of the ceiling,
and the lights will be flashing, and then the walls will collapse, and Andy will be standing there, a man who doesn't like surprises. Dear Dad, who knows? Who knows how he's going to deal with this surprise? Okay, and then with a bit of luck, he will agree to perform at the end of the show. So we're about to bring him up to the stage to give him this massive surprise. But first, we're going to have a little bit of fun because two of those actors actually have microphones in their ear and we can communicate with them. So let's see if we can talk to Richard. Where's Richard? Richard, if you can hear me, scratch your nose. Gemma, if you can hear me, sneeze quite violently.
Oh, so sorry.
He is very unimpressed by that. Richard, can you have your hand up, please? Can you just raise your hand with a question? Okay, Richard, your question is going to be, I've heard the phrase, there's no smoke without fire, but is that actually true?
Sorry. I've heard the phrase, there's no smoke without fire.
Yeah.
But, like, is that actually true?
You can have fires that smoulder away without any fire for hours and hours on end.
Can you follow this up with, what about smoke machines in discos?
If you haven't got enough oxygen, it doesn't got
it's
the right...
Not yeah, but what about smoke machines in discos?
What about them?
Okay, Gemma, when you can you just say
real smoke.
Coral, that's the person sitting in front of you, Coral's too embarrassed to ask, but can you do a fireman's lift on her?
Once it gets the right mixture of heat, oxygen...
Sorry, Coral, this is my friend Coral, she's a bit too embarrassed to ask, but she really wants you to do a fireman's lift on her.
It's up to you. I mean, doing it. If you've got some...
I'm heavier than I look.
You're not heavy.
Oh my god.
Do you just want me to do it?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Right, it's just in case.
Oh my god!
Yay!
Gemma, could you say that Coral also wants to know if you have any photos of you in uniform?
Any more questions?
Coral wants to know whether you've got any photos of you in uniform. She said that.
I have one photo here on my...
Are you serious?
Come on!
No, it's me and my dad. My dad was a firefighter.
Or out tomorrow.
Yeah, it's very good.
All right, normal questions now, normal questions.
Anyway.
Yeah, sure.
Any more questions?
Is it about Coral?
It's not about Coral.
Okay. I think, as a husband, he behaved very admirably. Yeah. Didn't he? Right. Can we bring Andy up with our little ruse?
Okay.
Hey guys. I don't know if you've just been aware of time, I haven't got much longer. You've got everything you need up here?
Extensions.
I couldn't ask one of you to just give me a hand. Is
that
alright?
Yeah, no,
just next door.
On general safety, mate.
If you're happy, just carry on for a bit. I'm just aware of time.
Absolutely fine.
Yeah, just come back.
So.
That was a bit of a walk, sorry. It's just next door in our next office. Yeah, we keep all our stuff down this end.
My kids are off school, aren't they?
And they, where are they, did you say? Sorry?
Where are my girls?
Where are your girls? Yeah, they're back home, are they? In bed. Yeah. It's probably late, isn't it, actually? If you can do me a favour, just grab... There's a water one in there.
Yeah.
There's another one upstairs that I'll just grab. You'll see it as you go in. If you just grab that for me.
Thank you.
It's Andy, ladies and gentlemen, Andy Quinn. There's your wife over there. There's your dad. Oh, good Lord, Andy. You are such a good firefighter that you've managed to avoid everything. Andy, this was supposed to douse you in foam and water, and you walked straight out. You're as clean as a whistle. Andy, don't panic. Don't panic. This is my television show. As you can see, your wife is over there, Emma, and your father and family and friends. And we are here, of course, to surprise you. We were hoping there was going to be a little bit more of a surprise at the end.
I'm not messing things up.
Oh, no, you haven't at all. Come over here and have a chat. So I'm going to go with what was supposed to happen. I've got a towel here to dry you off because I know you're covered in... in all the foam and the water. Right. And, of course, here is a carpet. Careful not to slip, because I know your feet are supposed to be very wet. Now, Andy, everything you've been doing here tonight isn't real. That fire safety course wasn't happening. Those people in the course are actors. So I don't know if we can see. They're all in on this. Yeah. They're all waving. Did you have any sense today that something was up?
I haven't got any sense at all, have I?
You haven't got any sense at all? Well, you have the sense to avoid everything we set up for you in the room. Well done for that.
So
they're still waving. That
might be on a loop. I don't know what's wrong with those people.
So tell me how you're feeling right now.
No idea.
Yeah, it's confusing.
Yeah.
You don't know what's happening,
no.
Do you? Well, you are going to be, hopefully, something that we call the unexpected star of the show, which is where we bring you to this theatre. You're in the Theatre Royal in Drury Lane. And hopefully, if you will agree, you will be performing. In front of over 2,000 people here. Now, you like performing, you like singing, you like musical theatre.
I did.
Theater. You did.
Could be the end of it tonight.
We have a whole production lined up, and I can't imagine more people rooting for you than we have here tonight. We're all on your side, Andy. So all that remains for me to do is to ask you, Andy, if you will be our unexpected star of the show tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, it's going to do it. Ladies and gentlemen, it's our firefighting unexpected star of the show, Andy! All right, there you go. Clean as a whistle! Ladies and gentlemen, my next guest is an international pop sensation. It is the absolutely wonderful, I'm so glad she's on my show, Ellie Goulding is here!
Fire and ice, this love is like fire and ice. This love is like rain and blue skies. This love is like sun on the rise. This love got me rolling the dice. Don't let me lose. Still falling for you. Still falling for you. It took us a while. With every breath a new day. With love on the line. We had our share of mistakes. But all your flaws and scars are mine. Still falling for you. Still falling for you. Just like that, oh, I breathe, oh, I feel, you are all for me, I'm in, and just like that, oh, I breathe, oh, I feel, you are all for me, and no one can lift me, catch me the way that you do, I'm still falling for you. and gold. This love shining brighter than gold. This love is like letters in bold. This love is like out of control. This love's never growing old. You make it new. Still falling for you. Still falling for you. It took us a while, 'cause we were young and unsure. We're love on the line. What if we both will need more? But all your flaws and scars are mine. So falling for you. So falling for you. And just like that, all of me, all of you, you are all for me. I'm in. And just like that, all of me, all of you, you are all for me. And no one can lift me, catch me the way that you do. I'm still falling for you.
In the last series, because, you know, we're looking, social media is obviously a very big part of everybody's lives, is that people, they tweet and do Instagrams, and I don't do this, so I don't really know what it means, but people are always updating what they're doing in their lives, and people here in the theatre were doing it, so I thought we'd have a little look at what was going on with you here tonight. So, yes, if you've been doing that, feel a little bit tense. So let's see. Oh, who are these people? Who are these two? Where are you? There they are. These people on our way to see Mr. McIntyre. There you are in the car, and you are wearing a comedy wig. Is that correct? is that true or not?
That's right. Yeah.
Is that your real hair?
Yeah, that's real.
That's fantastic. Is that, are you boyfriend and girlfriend?
Yeah.
Amazing. Sorry, that shouldn't. Sorry. I was way too happy for you. Then. Okay. And what are your names?
Jake.
Jake. Yeah. Hi, well, welcome. Thank you so much for coming. And that is very funny. Okay, so welcome. Anybody else? Anybody else been posting anything? Oh, we've got this gentleman. Who's this? Who's this? Worldies. Who are these people? Down here? What does that mean, worldies?
Pretty people.
Pretty people are called worldies. You can't just invent terminology on the spot. Well, I'm going to come down and say hi to you. So here you are. And your name is up there, isn't it? Josh, is that you? Lamptey, 1 hour ago. Boom. And who's that gentleman with you?
It's my granddad.
All right. Hi.
Nowhere.
Oh, no. This is adorable! What's your name, Grandpa?
Norman.
Norman. So you're worldies?
Yeah. Absolutely peng.
You're what?
Peng.
Peng? This is a completely different language that only your family speak. Can I ask you, so you post a lot on social media.
Yeah.
Josh.
Nah, don't.
In fact, Josh, maybe you could stand up for us. It's Josh, everyone, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, what a fine figure of a
Josh. So, Josh, now, we know that you are a bit of a poster of all sorts of photos of yourself. I wouldn't call you shy. Grandpa, can you stand up? Ladies and gentlemen, it's Norman, Josh's grandpa. Oh, look at those two. So, now, Norman, actually, Josh, came to us, and he's very intrigued by your lifestyle on social media.
Oh, my God.
And he wants our help to get involved. So, using your social media to inspire Grandfather Norman.
Oh, my days.
Norman has set up an Instagrams.
Oh. Class.
So let's have a little look at one of your selfies. Oh, there you are. What a fine figure of a man you are, Josh.
Oh, my days, mate. This is the most embarrassing thing that has ever happened to me in my life.
Yes, you say that, but you posted it online.
I am such a moron.
I don't remember your privacy settings not allowing this. So, Norman, inspired by this, thought he'd have a little go. Look at the guns on Norman.
There's not more, is there?
No, no. Just a few. So, any more selfies? Oh, dear. Josh, I feel this needs some explanation. What are you doing here?
Being a tool. Okay. I'm going to get so ripped for this. Oh, my God.
Well, let's see how Instagram has handled this photo. Okay. Any more? Any more? Have we got any more of these?
No.
Hopefully. Josh hopes we... Oh! Right.
Oh, my days, you're going to...
All right, Instagrams, how did you handle this?
Oh, my days.
Okay, now, Josh, can we just ask, what do you do for a living? What do you do at the moment?
I'm a student.
You're a student?
Yeah.
And do you do anything else? Part-time?
Yeah. This is so cringy.
What, part-time, Josh?
Model.
Ooh. Part-time model? I wonder if any of your modelling shots are in the public domain. Oh! Look at that! What are you thinking? What's the motivation behind this one? Is it you forgetting how one potato, two potato goes? Very cool. So, what happened here is that Grandpa Norman thought he would try and get involved in a little bit of modelling himself. Let's have a look at how that played out.
Hiya, Norman. I'm Rob. Hi. I'm your photographer.
Right.
I think the first thing to do, we'll get you into makeup.
Makeup?
You're joking.
He's a poser, isn't he? You know.
Yeah, looking really good there, Norman. Give me a little bit of a pout, just like Josh would do.
Yeah, perfect.
Shoulders back.
Very nice, looking really dapper.
I think these might be better than Josh's. I thought Norman took direction really well.
Can he for the win?
Poses were good.
Whoops.
And to be honest, I think he gave Josh a run for his money.
I can't compare with Josh, but he was brilliant having a try. Now I've got something to post on social media.
Yeah! Oh, what about that? Let's hear it for Instagram's Norms! fantastic.
Oh, my God.
Josh, what do you want to say to Gramps Norman?
Oh, he's absolutely class, isn't he? He's cooler than me by a mile.
Did you enjoy that, Norm?
I did, yes. Very I enjoyed good. It.
Let's. Have you got your phone on you now? Let's the three of us take a selfie and round this up. And we'll get this out there. What an absolute legend. Let's hear it for Grandpa Norman. And Joshie! Let's have it. Well done. Fantastic. Great fun. Excellent. Instagram, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that was funny. Oh, my days. Oh, my days. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, it is now time to play Celebrity Centaur. Superstar Ollie Murs agreed to hand over his phone and I sent a text message to his contacts and this is the message that I sent. Just going through the contacts in my phone, really sorry, but can you remind me how I know you or I'm going to have to delete you? Ollie. Well, replies have been flooding in and it is now time to find out what has happened. All right, so let's see what we've got here. Oh, it's a great one. Scotty Neighbour. What do you think Scotty Neighbour put?
I haven't got a clue.
I think it's quite obvious. Scott, I live next door.
Oh, God.
Chris Moyles?
Yes.
Oh, great response from Chris Moyles.
Oh, no.
My name is Lola and I'm a showgirl. Waggy? Okay.
Yeah, Wag is... Wag does, he's a mate of mine for years,
yeah.
But he cleans my cars for me. He's yeah, cleans. No, it's what he does for a job. He's a valet, he does valeting and all that. It's,
okay.
I don't
it's
ask,
Adam
I didn't
Waggy.
Just say to him, can you clean my car? He does it for a job.
But he's first and foremost a friend.
Yeah, he's a friend.
Backed up by this text. It's Adam Waggy, I clean your cars.
Right?
Melvin? Melvin O'Doom. Oh,
yes.
I love him.
Love Mel.
Yeah.
Yeah, good luck.
Ha-ha, it's Melvin O'Doom. And then he's put, from Kiss FM, stroke, extra factor, stroke, strictly, bro, please don't delete me. He's listed all his credits.
Love Mel.
Name one more TV credit. Or it's Delete City.
Are you actually sending this back?
I don't know, it's up to the audience. Yeah! Okay, that's gone to Melvin. Delivered. Kirk Setford.
Another close mate.
Cheeky. I played football for you for years and hung out before you could sing and pull birds. It's all gone for you, my friend. John Pollard, who's that?
That's my uncle. That's
your uncle?
Rachel's husband.
This is your husband, John Pollard. And you're here tonight, and he's texted, who is this? I don't seem to have your number. You're joking!
That's my uncle!
That's his uncle.
He's having a wind-up.
Slates. Oh, he sounds like a good mate.
Yeah, Slates is cool.
Slates, yeah. You just got Murs, it's Slates. Don't delete me.
Okay.
Rochelle. This is a great one.
Rochelle. Marvin and Rochelle.
Love Rochelle. Murs, you're so showbiz these days. Rochelle, the brown one from the Saturdays? There's more. That married that rather tall, annoying guy from JLS?
Rochelle.
I think Ollie Murs has been an incredible sport, don't you? I think he's a legend. It's Ollie Murs, legend!
Okay.
Thank you so much, Ollie. Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are moments away now from our unexpected star performance. But before we introduce him, let's have a little look at how he's been getting on.
I came to London to do a fire safety talk. Went to get a fire extinguisher and somehow ended up on Michael McIntyre's show. Now I've got to sing a song. Yeah, I still don't know what's hit me. I'm not prepared.
Yes, you are.
I think I'm coming to terms with it, I think.
So Andy came in, obviously still in shock from what just happened. I think obviously he's out of his comfort zone because he's never been on the West End and it's a dream of his.
How am I feeling about the song? The song's got a lot of dynamics in it. It's very powerful and very soft at the same time, so that's probably what's the most concerning thing.
We need to give you to Wardrobe.
This has been something I've talked about for years, never for 1 minute thought it would happen. I'm excited about singing to my family and some good friends in the audience. But I've just got to go out and give it my all and hope that when I look back at the end of it, I'm happy.
That's all been going on. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up. The wonderful, our unexpected star of tonight's show, it's firefighter Andy!
God on high, hear my prayer. In my need, you have always been there. He is your afraid. Let him rest, heaven blessed. Bring him home, bring him home, bring him home. He's like the sun I might have known. If God had granted me a son, the summer. And I am old and will be gone. Bring him peace, bring him joy. He is young. He is only a boy. You can take, you can give. Let him be, let him live.
ladies and gentlemen, what about that? Our unexpected star of the show, Barbara Landy! Incredible. I think that was pretty remarkable. How did that feel?
All right.
You enjoy it?
Yeah, I enjoy it now. It's done.
Dad, how did you feel watching that?
I'm blown away, mate. I'm blown away.
Yeah. Very, very talented. Is this mine?
It's mine.
How did you enjoy that?
Oh, it was just amazing. I've never, ever heard him sing that song, and I've always wanted to hear him sing it.
Yeah, it's beautiful. Well, let's talk to the lady who does get to bring him home. How did you enjoy that, Emma?
Oh, I'm just so proud of you.
Yeah. I hope it was all that you wanted it to be, was it?
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time. Absolutely fantastic. I'd expect the star of the show. There he is. It's Barbara Landy and his family. Wonderful. Go and enjoy the moment. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for everybody in the panel tonight. We will see you again next week for another big show. Until